Welcome back, everybody. It is another week, another 4PL Cup, and we'll be doing it over today as well as tomorrow. The grand finals are tomorrow, but of course, for today, we go through all the groups, all the rounds, to see just how far we can get. For those guys out there that want to check out all the details, you can head yourself over to the 4PL website. So 4pl.de is the place to head to. This is our grid we're currently looking at our next round. So obviously, get round one, round two, round three, round four is what we're up to. So Z4, we're being told, is a bit more of a surprise team. Who is who? You're never really 100% sure of. And going up against Pain Gaming, a team which we know very, very much from the defense. So they'll be our two opponents for tonight. If you want to check out the details, as well as a bit of a Facebook competition, you can actually win yourself yet again another headset. Of course, this is sponsored by Sennheiser, so they are able to give away these awesome free goodies. So if you want to do that, head yourself over to facebook.com/4playersLIGA. And you'll find everything that you want to have as far as instructions go for winning the PC 100 2GO headset. Check it out. Do it. All right, so let's check out our game, though. That's the thing we want to see. So Z4, they'll be over on the Dire side for this game. We'll be having Pain Gaming over on the Radiant side. Of course, we've been having ourselves some interesting times when it comes to... when it's come to drafting earlier this evening. So we'll see what we get this time around. We see the Gyro, Batrider, as well as SD. Gyro able to get through the Batrider, able to get through the ban pool. Same with Nyx and Darkseer, because we had the Magnetor as well as the Undying being banned out. The two normal core supports, which see the Wisp as well as the Coddle being removed from this game. And Pain Gaming, interesting combinations for them. We've got Darkseer as well as Disruptor. So just those two heroes together. We're looking at a lot of teamfight control. And also a lot of control over heroes before they get BKBs. But once the BKBs come up for Gyro as well as Batrider, they won't be as intimidated by those two heroes. And the one thing they've got to worry about is the fact that Nyx can initiate very early on. And when that happens, then you don't have time to get those BKBs off and running. But one thing he does have is SD. So if you can't get the BKB off in time, get the disruption up and running. And SD, because we did see him combine up pretty nicely with the Gyro. I said, no, it was the other way around, wasn't it? But they do combine up nicely. Get the disruption off, and it gets all the repositioning time in the world for the Batrider to move around.
10 seconds remaining.
And we're going to have for our next set of bans, so taking out the Nakes.
5 seconds remaining.
And when you think about Pain's lineup, we are still, well, we've got Long Lane, we've got possible two supports, possible, also both of them can run the mid-solo. But up against a Batrider, they'll be looking for something else. So Z4, they could also be looking at running that Gyro middle lane. Batrider's the more stable one, though. But up against the Nyx, Batrider probably won't feel too comfortable in the early portions of the game. So we've already talked about the best way that Nyx can run up against a Batrider, mana burn level 1, grab a stick at level 1, 2. And then head yourself out into the lane every single time he throws a napalm. You get yourself a charge. Health and mana come back your way while you continue to remove his mana. And Z4 taking a long time here on this fourth ban. Well, they worry about just banning up that number one position, and that's all. Anybody that's able to stand their ground with Gyro as well as Batrider. Someone in the later portion of the game. Someone with teamfight control. We've already got Darkseer and Disruptor. I would have suggested Faceless Void, but he almost doesn't help out with Darkseer and Disruptor. It's another area of effect controller. So when it comes to the team fights, it's still going to be strong. But it doesn't synergize as well because you can't do as much damage as you want to do. Darkseer wants to make the most of these illusions, but they get caught inside the wall. And there's still the option for Z4 to go with a Rubik pickup. Maybe that's what Pain might be juggling up right now. Like, do we ban out the Rubik? Do we take out the Beastmaster instead? So they take out a hero which has that roar that will go through the BKB. Are they worried about the offlaner? They're not worried about Aura Strat. That's definitely not coming out here from Z4. Last ban now by Z4. So we take another hard carry, just take out the PL. It almost feels like they're banning out heroes they just don't want to play against in the late portion of the game. But there's still the anti-mage. And again, anyway, it just took too long to get the farm and Batrider control him too much. And SD will just turn him around. It's a bit of a surprise too that we see PL being banned out when you've also got the SD and the Gyro on the field. Cleaning off the illusions is no real issue for both the Gyro, and SD would just replicate and then just create his own. That's the beauty about the Shadow Demon. When he works against the PL in that manner. And the last band's going to be Lina. So Lashrak and Lina, it's the old combinations that combine it with the SD. And maybe that's what they're thinking. We saw a different combination early tonight, which is with the Kunkka. Worked out very, very nicely. And the Kunkka also a dangerous hero to have on the field up against Nyx. Nyx can just hunt him so damn well. We'll see.
10 seconds remaining.
We'll see if Nyx ends up in the middle lane, gets that early level 6.
5 seconds remaining.
Z4. Got to make their 4 selection now. Do we go for our extra support? Do we look towards our hard carry? Or is Batrider actually going to go that mid lane? So they're going to get support to start with. So Chen's going to be up their sleeve. Which does lead towards a lone druid being their final one. Just still depends on where they want to throw that Batrider, if he's going to be long late or not. Also, if Payne want to go aggressive, now with the Chen pickup by Z4, they're not going to have this early game presence like we've seen Enchantress has already picked up a lot of recent times because it adds this early game presence. But Chen doesn't really have that. There's this couple of minutes at the very, very start where he has very little to no influence on the lanes. But if you let him farm up, then he'll have a big influence on the mid to the late portion of the game. So Payne with two more pickups. Really surprising, considering they got the Disruptor, the Darkseer, as well as the Nyx. I thought they would have had this a little bit more like planned out for what they're looking to pick up. I always get a little bit iffy about it during drafting times when you're eating a lot of your extra time. It could just be because I like to talk things out a hell of a lot. But most of the time, yeah, and I got a funny feeling that was the conversation. With a lone druid and a Chen behind you, you can bring down most towers, almost anything, really. But by picking him up, they block off Z4 from getting that last pick. Z4 won't have that lone drill for the pushing power. For guys out there that are asking for it too, yeah, Silencer is available. This will be hosted on tournament mode, which is where Silencer is available. But we're going to go with the Brewmaster instead. So we go classic counters again. See the classic band out against what's going to work with the SD. And this time around, we just go with the Brewmaster. Get the Broodling split, get that bear up in the air as early as possible, but only, well, actually, not even if it has radiance or not, it's still worthwhile getting that bear up in the air. As I saw in our previous game, entangles can happen at any point of the game, and you've just got to be ready for it. Prepared and ready to rock and rumble.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
So our last pickup. Pain Gaming. Are they going to look for more stability of this? More team fight? Do they try and take a jungler of their own? Leave Darkseer up on the top. Nyx in the middle lane. Lone Druid and Disruptor can be perfectly happy on the bottom lane. And yeah, there's our jungler and another team fight controller. So Enigma comes the way of Pain Gaming. And that's going to be our full lineups. So let's get ourselves into it. Just a reminder too, guys, if you want to win yourself a decent headset, head yourself over to the Facebook page of 4PL. There is a raffle right now for a PC 100 2GO. If you want to get involved, all you got to do is follow the instructions. I'm actually not quite sure the instructions myself. I had my head over there. I was like, oh, okay, so there's a couple of streams going on. I'm guessing just comment or like or do whatever. If you've got a Facebook account, it's like the easiest thing in the world. But yeah, just head yourself over to 4Players, LIGA, and you'll be able to find the details about that one. Remaining. And maybe win yourself a cool Sennheiser headset. All right, let's get ourselves inside the game.
5 seconds remaining.
I'm hearing that announced with 5 seconds. I don't want to wait 5 seconds. Pick your hero. Let's go. Let's go. I'm in for Dota. I want to see some good Dota, guys. I want to see some good Dota. Looks like we'll have ourselves a quick pause. Man, Chen, what has he got on him? A red turban. Man, that's one pimped out Chen. As much as you can get on him. Only one rare thing. The headpiece is the rare part of it all. And Pain Gaming. Man, it's been a while since I've actually got to cast Fuga. Fuga, Billy, King Red, GK, and Grant. We'll get ourselves started in a moment. Looks like our last player has selected, so we'll be good to go. Just also a bit of a reminder for everything else that's coming up tonight. If you missed the games from earlier this evening, do not worry about that. The VODs will be uploaded to youtube.com/joindota. And we'll also, as always, have a restream after tonight's broadcast for those guys out there in the American time zone that can't get home from work or are busy on their Sunday afternoons. We'll have a restream for you a little bit later on this evening. We'll have ourselves some more fun. We've also got more games coming up this evening too. This is the last round before we head ourselves into round 5. And then we'll start to see a little bit more of what's in store for us. And as far as the teams which managed to get through, looks like 3D Max as well as KP still able to slip themselves through these early stages. The Retry is still going to play a couple of their games. I'm going to actually refresh my grid over on the side here. Yeah, the Retry has managed to get through. They're playing up against Phantoms right now. Quirt, I haven't seen them in a while. They're also able to get themselves through into round 4. And KP, they're just awaiting their next opponent. Dream Hunters currently playing up against Ilma's Corner. Just remind the players, like, you guys, what's going on? Like to smoothly move through this competition. As they're just sitting here with no words saying the reason why we had a pause from Chen. So yes, 2 minutes. They need 2 minutes. On the bright side, it gives you guys time if you haven't done so. So let's see how many people we can do that, because right now I know these kind of competitions, guys, they don't happen without the sponsors. So if you can, go over and support them. Just take your Facebook account, head yourself over, and head yourself over to this website, this place right here. I'll even link it up inside the chat in a moment. But the 4PL... the 4PL Facebook page, just come over here. Okay, so it's actually going to send you to this raffle page. Click on the I'd like to take part in the raffle. Okay, so that's it. That's all you got to do. Just click the like button here and you can take part in the raffle. So that's how simple this is. That is how simple it is. So get yourself in, have yourself some fun. And let's get underway. So game is a go, game is good. And we'll get our lanes up and running. So heading down towards the bottom lane already, so Nyx will head down here with the support of Fuzzy. Coming in behind him will be Fuga. Let's just say the entire team. Billy's also down here. Oh, almost the entire team. Grant's just a little bit too far behind, but looks like with 4 clarities and building in towards the Sol Ring, he is looking to stay inside that jungle for a decent amount of time. And already the ping's coming out. What are they looking at? The T1? T1 and T2 tower in the bottom lane? Not quite sure if they're looking to defend it or not. It's like Z4 will be running the Batrider on the long lane. Undead's just remaining here in the middle lane, just to deward in case they need it. And Rudolph already going to go for a bottle rush. And support Gyro. Nope, it is going to be position 1 for the Gyro on the top lane. And the SD will try and help out. Let me just spam up the link for the thing. There we go. Just remind myself to do it after 2 minute delay. I just had a small little crash of some stuff over on my side.
The battle begins.
We're good to go again. So very, very passive for the early points. Just early warning. Sentry ward's already down here in the mid, on the bottom lane. But that's not where the wards are being focused by Payne. Payne have decided to put the both Observer and Sentry Ward up towards the top lane. Smarter position at the end of the day to throw it by putting it up on that high ground. They know if there's ever going to be a smoke gank coming in from someone like the original retry, then they'll have that option. And Observer Ward, they easily see it. They'll easily get rid of that one. That's 100 gold wasted. Well, not even that. 75 gold now, isn't it? But Fuzzy will come up and get rid of it. But he does it by the fact of doing that. He reveals the fact they do have a Sentry Ward there. So hoping of catching out the smoke gank by Chen, who is walking around with smoke. He doesn't have much more than smoke. But by doing that, he does reveal that fact. They could have possibly used that as a bait. Bit more of a trap. They'll see it coming from a mile off. Man, Rudolph, where's your life, dude? He's trying to stay as close as he possibly can to get this bottle up and running, but he's one stun away from death. And if King Red, Rudolph's in too close. Rudolph's in way too close. Harassment damage. Where's the stun? Where's the stun? He's still got the whole tower, the creep wave with him next to the tower. And Rudolph using these Tango charges, getting more life as this goes on. So King Red misses opportunity. Looks like all he wanted was the bottle. He meanwhile up on the top lane. Darkseer should go down. Is this be our first blood? Maybe not. Retreat away. The Iron Shell damage was a little bit too intimidating for the Gyro to stick around. So he'll pop off his salve and move back to a safer lane. Well, not to a safe lane, to a safer point of the lane, which is a little bit further back from the tier 1 tower. How's the bottom lane looking? So Fuga, higher CS in the bottom lane, because Batarang never going to get him really close with this Disruptor, depending on how much Disruptor is able to spam out. Rune run now going to happen, so, well, we have a double damage on the bottom. He was guessing for that one. But guess correctly, you chose wisely. Same time as King Red wants to check for it too. Both end up just walking down for no apparent reason. Oh, well, King Red walks down for no reason. They'll see the DD now inside the bottle of Rudolph. And instantly activated. Looking for some easy aggression up on the Nyx. Probably didn't really need to do that considering he was already full health and mana could have saved that for a little bit later on. Well, he's looking to initiate properly, but maybe CS escapes him for the moment, so he wants to get ahead. And right now, he is basically leveled up. Not completely, but basically leveled up with King Red. Now, stacks begin by Batrider. Gyro can come in and farm this one up a little bit later, so obviously that's the duty of this Batrider. You'll get levels when Gyro comes in to farm it. But until that point, whoop, disruption, catcher, Gyro, should be our first blood. Should be our first blood. Nice body block there by the original retry. All it was an easy disruption after that catcher happened, and then body blocked him in with both of his illusions, as well as his own body. And Darkseer, trying to make a different choice. There was that choice to either run east or run west. If he ran west, then he might have actually been safer, but he tried to juke it around a little bit more, make a decision that wasn't expected from Z4. So he went right instead of going left. Z4 in a better position for it then. Meanwhile, on the bottom lane, Pain. First blood might go on the top lane, but Enigma comes out of the jungle with Sol Ring and almost hitting level 5. So in fact, now it does hit it. So they have some powerful converge that's going to hit on this tier 1 tower in the bottom lane. And they shouldn't have to stop here. Easy to take out the tier 2 tower. Fuga's Bear's tanking it up for now. No problem with a resummon. And there goes the tower. Keep the momentum rolling. Can a push out here from the Dire side. Z4, they're nowhere near ready for this. Batrider's trying to take care of the stacks, which have been set up for him very, very nicely. Just a couple of napalm stacks up to level 4. Because he's been missing. Even if he does come down towards his bottom lane, there's no way they can stop this push. Question is, if this stops here at the tier 2 tower. Question is answered. Pain might be a little bit too over-aggressive if they try and push it out that far. But rotating around, taking in other towers with this same level of push, it's well worth it. Still no level 6 up on the Brewmaster. And even if there is a level 6, like, their mana burn will still come out. It's a regeneration rune, the bottle of Nyx. So he's happy to spam off all of his abilities. So he's trying to come a little bit closer towards Rudolph. He gets the two bottle charges off, but he's nowhere near. Even if he does have, whoop, hello, top lane. Dive coming out in Fuzzy, able to eat through a tree line, and now look for a big stun to come out here from King. He's got two heroes lined up. I think he's waiting for the three of them. Trying to come in behind Undead, and there he goes. Two on the stun. He does lose the Darkseer and use Vendetta to initiate. Now he's too far in over his head. That's why we're already seeing Chen. Nice movement of the Troll Warlock. Get in the front lines. Hold King Red out. Then the trap. Nice stun, however. Returns through. All three of them line themselves up. Quick bottle. And then retreat out. So still a one-for-one trade. Darkseer for the Chen. Which may not seem like much, but when you're trying to go up against a counter-push, or going up against a push lamp like we've already seen by Pain, you need those levels up on the Chen. You need to have these extra creeps at his disposal. And more importantly, you need to have that mech up and running. Invis rune to be swiped, or actually, no, going to be held. At least Brewmaster will have enough mana for his ultimate, but still not enough for a full combo. You can pop the Invis and get one charge off of that bottle, and that will give enough for the combination. But still a dangerous thing if he gets mana burned. And that's all King Red wants to do. And that's what makes this middle lane so difficult for Rudolph. Brewmaster's going up against Nyx. It's just, it's free farm for a Nyx and never really having to fear that aggression. Most of the time whenever I broadcast, I always say, hey, level 6 hits on Brewmaster, you got to watch him like a hawk. You basically got a brew cam. Because he should be the one finding the kills with his ultimate. But the downside of it is he gets mana burned up. And he doesn't have this mana pool that he requires until he gets what he's now got, which is the Arcane Boots. It just means he's a little bit slower on getting the Blink Dagger, and now, easy initiation. The Invis attack with the Iron Shell damage, Gyro Felder coming, is like, what the hell is this? The Vendetta hit, and the Impale stun. More than enough initiation. Same as initiation we're going to see it from Batrider. Batrider, nicely played with the Spike Carapace. Walked into the Firefly, so the damage will be reflected Batrider's way, so he couldn't get close enough to get this. The Lasso, Fuzzy couldn't get back in range of the T1 tower in time. The Surge was too long on cooldown. King Red trying to do what he could. He's here in the middle lane, so here's our push, our rotation push. That's all Pain really has to do, just move from Tier 1, Tier 2 tower, and take out lane after lane. And now he's waiting for the rotation. You're already going to find one out, so stun. Mana burn him up, already leaving at the wall. Mana burn him, or else that disruption was going to happen as well as the catcher. Looks like Red wanted to save his mana. Tier 1 tower cannot be saved, it will go down. Careful of Brewmaster getting in too close. A quick glimpse and he can find himself back in range of a Malphite stun. Still a Tier 1 for a Tier 1 tower trade. Wasn't a denial on the top, I don't believe. Nope, Darkseer didn't deny it. Destroyed by the Radiant, destroyed by the Dire. So the full Moonlight comes their way. And Nyx already wants to hunt. They've taken out three towers for the price of one. As far as the pressure on their own towers, mid tower's been scratched a little. Bottom tower hasn't even been touched. Iron Shell, Vendetta. Yeah, Iron Shell, Vendetta, remove. Even giving him a surge to come up, and he's already found one. Sticking right behind, gets the stun, Brewmaster. Even if he wants to clap on that one, he was not going to have any time to do so. Red didn't really want to have to use that mana burn. It is, at the end of the day, a waste of mana when he's trying to get that kill, but he also wanted to ensure the kill before Brewmaster could do anything in response. Which Brewmaster did nothing in response. All he could do was just sit there and watch. And hope he gets enough time to save up for his blink. And give the initiation that Z4 desperately need. He's got the phase boost plus that Ring of Aquila and a bracer up on Gyro. I'm hoping that's also going to be drums flying down to him. And in fact, I am correct, it is the drums. So not too bad for Gyro. Still lone druid. A man with more money. Running ahead of Midas. So easy farm for him. Is that it's really five-man Dota we're seeing already coming out from the Dire side? I think it is. Chen's coming in with three sets of creeps. And a hand of God. And a Brewmaster Omelette, why wouldn't you want to force it? Oh, wait, Mana Burn. Hurts like hell. He's already used his Arcane Boots, but they'll come off cooldown in a moment. They're trying to force down the tower. Fortification is available for the Radiant side if they want to use it. But keep with these conversions, get rid of the Chain Creeps, already taking out most of them, and Nick's middle of the engagement with the Vendetta. Who's he really want to go for? He's just doing harassment damage right now, and there's a long glimpse, pulling Rudolph a long way back. He's still going to split instantly. They've got to help out for this one. Already trouble. Bully. He will go down. Enigma sent up and towards the air. He'll come down. He's got the black hole, but not really, really useful when the Brewmaster's already got his ulti down. But the Mech Charge, that will be useful. Brewmaster Omen now going to wear off. Now the fight can be turned around. Trying to go on the Gyro. Malivus stun and an Entangle to boot. Is Batrider hoping to find a snipe there? That just shows you the level of control that comes out from the Brewmaster Ultimate. Managed to disable everything in the back lines of pain. While Nyx was able to find one kill. He can normally do that himself solo. We've seen him do it time and time again already in this match. Let alone all the other games of Dota we've watched. And the problem is there was just no other deaths. The fight always got split into two because of the harassment Nyx was... the damage Nyx was doing. Force the Dino side to look behind. Oh, trouble, trouble. Spike Carapace, return the damage. And then the wall, holding him out and holding him in. Remember, there's no ultimate this time from the Brewmaster, giving a full time into the black hole, plus the ultimate out. Coming from the Disruptor. So the silence, the damage, the control. 9-4, and a mech charge. There's no reason why they have to stop. Batrider may be up and running, and he does have a Blink Dagger. But he's got no TP scroll. He spent all of his cash on the Blink Dagger. He'll have to walk himself all the way back to base. See him use his Blink just then to try and get back a little bit faster. Disruption and Catcher, no real problem. Tier 3 tower is the main thing they want. And a new creep wave comes up at the same time as the tower, but then conversion just made from it. Batrider will still look for an opening. Fuga resummons his bear. They want this tower. They can take this Rax. We're 12 minutes in. They're going to surge out. Everyone comes back up again. Maybe they don't know the timing exactly of the Brewmaster Ultimate. There's still not the minute before it comes off cooldown. Even Hand of God's on cooldown for the moment. But they do take yet another tower. So 5 towers for Pain, and all they've lost is one. You can see that gold advantage just coming up. Same with the experience. Finding these critical heroes to go down. Of course, a death to Rudolph. Send him back on that Blink Dagger. And in we go again. Vendetta. Wait, whoa, 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 whoa. You're taking damage. You've got to move back instantly when you know the Nyx is on the hunt. Gyro's already dead. Glimpse. It's available. Yep, pull him back. Put the wall up. And now they've got him. Even the ulti popping down from Billy. Just in case Rudolph has his ulti. Blink by Red. Trying to go on the one hero that can escape him with a Blink Dagger. But it's a double kill. And they can push up that middle end and take a Rax. But are we really going to do it the safe way? Yeah, we're going to do it the safe way. Lone Druid's up on the top, so we'll take Tier 1 and Tier 2 on the outside first. The Brazilians showing their strength here. Even Relic up on the bear. And with the tower going down the top lane, that will be enough to get that full Radiance up and running. Courier, however, being used a little bit more, so we'll have the Urn as well as Arcane Boots fly in. Oh. Except for the courier that has no idea where the hell it's going. So we get it for Billy. There's our urn, and then the Arcane Boots heading over to... okay, so we're going to go to Darkseer. Interesting build from the Darkseer. One Soul Ring is enough, I'm guessing. Goes the Arcane and the Vanguard instead. No big Iron Shell spam, but there is a Blink Dagger up on the Enigma now. No Black Hole, however. 40 seconds on the cooldown. All ulti's back up again, apart from the original retry, because he's not level 6 just yet. Same with Darkseer. He's also, well, I say he's not level 6, he just hasn't leveled up his ulti, which he won't do until level 11. And then our last one, which was the Disruptor who had his ulti on cooldown, but it's come off. So they can still force out the top lane. Ooh, hello smoke. But they did it in range of a Siege Creep. So it's very obvious they've smoked right now. I'm guessing that was a misclick. Has to be a misclick. Batrider's moved a long way up on the top. Looking for a good lasso. And look for the Enigma when Enigma jumps in. Enigma now with the Black Colt off cooldown. Does he go for Enigma or does he go for the Nyx? And he goes for the Enigma. Picks him up, which means there's no easy control over on Rudolph until that ulti comes down from the Disruptor. Disruption will buy a little bit of time here. Fuzzy will go down. That's a lot of damage coming out from the Gyro. And the Brewmaster Split already being used trying to bring down this Lone Druid's Bear. Successful at doing so. Fuga does have a resummon. Oh, he's in range of a sentry! Spire Carapace as fast as he possibly could once he realized that fact. But the Earth Brewling with the Sun, Enigma blinks himself in. He can go for the Black Hole right now, and he's managed to pick up Rudolph. The wall is there. Rudolph is just on the edge, but they haven't killed him off in time. Malivus done. Wall tick him over. And the Radiant Sperm was also helping out at the same time. Not the smoothest of executions coming out from either of the sides. Turned into a little bit more of a clusterbuck just then. And now they move on to the tier 2 tower on the top lane. There is already one hero TPing down towards the bottom lane, so that's going to be Fuzzy. The man who died. Dire's top tower has fallen. But all now the talents have been removed by Pain, 16 minutes in. So great cash coming their way. They get another smoke by Z4. Looking for that blink to Lasso, but Lasso on cooldown for 13 seconds time. So they don't really have a good opening here. Split push? 1800 up on the bear. Suppose by pushing up this bottom lane after using that Hand of Minus in a moment, he would have enough to buy up that Hyperstone, but instead goes in. We've got Tranquil Boots up on him and a TP scroll as well. Got Roshan. That's where the pings are coming. It's coming out from the Nyx. Taking all the outer towers. C4 stuck inside their own base, so hey, why don't we just go for Roshan? Grab a gem, we can't be surprised. They lose it though, then Nyx is not going to be happy, but then again, Nyx is the man who's carrying it himself. And there's Batrider, searching for a lasso out. Knows exactly what's going on. This is the opening right now that Z4 needed. Maybe if they can find themselves a good couple of kills, they're doing this while the Enigma Black Hole's on cooldown. The bear can be resummoned in a moment. Conversions pushed up towards the high ground, but now the conversion's actually giving some vision. That's why the clamp has to happen. Clean off the line. Nyx was thinking about coming in a little bit closer just then. Pulled against it though. As Roshan sits at half of his life. Shadow Poison trying to give him the vision, but they're out. They're moving. They're looking for an opening. Sentry's still here in the middle lane, so they're still looking out for that Nyx. Surprisingly, the Pain Gaming, they search out inside the Dire Jungle, even though Z4 were still feeling that they were going to take Roshan, which means all five heroes from Z4 must have been there. But they check the jungle instead. And there's the dewarding. Get rid of those sentries with the gem. To get their own vision up on that high ground. So you can see exactly what's going to happen. If anyone tries to rotate in, they still don't have some good vision for what comes from this direction. And that's why smoke to blink is a dangerous thing. Whoop, there goes the blink already. Comes in, only finds the bear, and then the split's going to happen. Is there time to get back inside of Vendetta? Not while it's on cooldown, and maybe even more trouble. Spy Carapace glimpsing it back out again, but there's the lasso, and it will be actually broken. It gets broken by the glimpse of Disruptor, and then Disruptor also splits the fight in half, and now Nyx can play around the way he wants to. Trying to pick off a couple of heroes. Rocket Barrage not going for his full duration because of this Spy Carapace. And now they can focus. Already Entangle's been done, but there's the extra sun out from Nyx. So Rudolph trying to TP himself back out to safety. Roshan at least denies the Batrider. And SD will limp himself back to base, but GG, it's the call. 18 minutes in, and I highly, highly agree. This game is over. There is no more. And Pain Gaming, they play it solid. They play it really, really solid. They knew what they could do. They pushed out nicely. Still a little bit of holes in their team fight. Well, it's the same to be said about the Dire side. Z4, their timing wasn't really right either. Those key items like Blink Daggers didn't pay off on both Brewmaster and the Batrider. Because they just lost so much so early. Makes for difficult, difficult times. It looks like they want to have a little bit more fun. They've called the GG. But and they're still going to play on to the bitter end. But it's probably going to be pretty damn bitter, especially if there's another Entangle coming up right now. Gyro gets a lock. And then Glimpse. And then three hits, four hits. Man, how many hits is he taking there? Finally, Entangle. We get sent back to base by the Chen, so instantly healing up. And the bear's going to go down here. There's no resummon on this guy, remember? Actually, oh, there is. The timing has passed long enough. There is the resummon on the bear. And Fuga will do it. Really should be putting an Iron Chill on the bear as well instead of the creep wave. So it's the bear who's standing still. And there goes the mid racks. Is E4 really going to keep fighting this one out, or is it like fake GG? Turn around and fight. Come on, bear. Look for an entangle. Second poor swipe. Disruption was the only thing that would save SD just then. Wonderful black hole. Four men caught in it. Back into the disruptor orbit. Plus the wall. Triple kill comes the way of the disruptor. And justifiably so, but it was the Enigma with the blink dagger. Z4 in the wrong position. And there we go. There's our disconnections. And we get our GG. So guys, we shall be returning in a couple of moments' time. We'll see what's coming up for next round. We hit ourselves into round 5 now of the 4PL Cup. Remember, head yourself over to the 4PL Facebook webpage. Facebook place, you know what. Win yourself an easy headset. Simple. Sennheiser giving them out and sponsoring this tournament. Thanks for watching, guys. Stick around. Next game coming up. Don't know when, but we'll find out soon.